So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session, guys, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams, whether it is central government exam or the state government exam or the regulatory body exams. See, kal session nahi ho paya tha, so I am bringing it today. And iske aage jo bhi schedule rehta hai Monday, Wednesday, Friday, wo waise ka waise hi rahega. Alright, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram channel or the group. Here you will get the PDF of this session and you can also ask any doubt here. And remember, guys, today's session is very important. Definitely one or two questions is coming from today's session only. Okay. So the very first question is regarding the PM Gati Shakti plan or PM Gati Shakti mission, you can also say. So you have to identify the correct statements regarding PM Gati Shakti plan. So let's discuss about the Pradhan Mantri Gati Shakti mission, or you can say the Gati Shakti plan. So Prime Minister has launched this and it was announced in the 15th August speech by the Prime Minister. So this plan is Gati Shakti, which is National Master Plan for Multimodal Connectivity. What is the meaning of multimodal? Multimodal ka matlab kya hota hai ki, like for example, ki yahan ye railway station hai, railway station se train gayi, then ek port tak gayi, then port se this train collected the saman and then it delivered it to another railway station. So basically all the modes of the transport included, theek hai, usko hum bolte hain multimodal transportation system. Theek hai, like for example ship, train and ship, train and जो भी road transport होता है, ये जब आपस में connect हो जाएगा, that will be known as multimodal connectivity. All right. Now this project has been launched for integrated planning and coordinated implementation of infrastructure in the country. Now remember, this PM Gati Shakti project or plan or mission is nothing new. Not a single new project will be launched under it. What they are doing is basically they are subsuming all the ongoing infrastructure projects under various government schemes. Like for example, there is a project Bharat Mala, you must have heard of that project Sagar Mala. Usi tarike se new airports which are being built under the Udaan scheme. So all the infrastructure projects will now be subsumed under a big scheme, or you can say the jo bada scheme hota hai jisko flagship program, and that flagship program is known as Gati Shakti Mission, Gati Shakti Project or Gati Shakti Plan. All right. So I hope this thing is clear. Now let's talk more about this. So remember, it will bring together the efforts of 16 ministries together. Okay, so basically the thing is that they are subsuming the different infrastructure project from different ministries, 16 ministries into one, under the one heading, and that is known as PM Gati Shakti Plan. It will incorporate the infrastructure schemes of various ministries and state governments, like for example these, and it will provide integrated and seamless connectivity to the movement of people and also the goods and services, because this is for the multimodal connectivity. Multimodal connectivity, let me repeat this, the different modes of transport, when they are connected, then that is known as multimodal connectivity, whether it is air transport, road transport, railways or the water transport. Jab ye sare aapas mein connect ho jate hain, then that is known as multimodal connectivity. All right, now talking more about this, so remember this is based on six pillars. The project is based on six pillars: comprehensiveness, prioritization, optimization, synchronization, analytical and dynamic. So they can also ask is tarike ka question aa sakta hai, which of the following is not one of the pillars on which the Gati Shakti plan is based. So ye six pillars you have to remember. Also remember that 11 industrial corridors and 2 defense corridors in Tamil Nadu and Uttar Pradesh will be constructed. So as I told you, no new project has been introduced till now, because you know this, these 2 defense corridors in Tamil Nadu and Uttar Pradesh are already under construction. So basically they have subsumed various infrastructure project under one heading, and that they are calling it as PM Gati Shakti. Now there are some targets of Ministry of Shipping which has been announced. PIB mein ye given tha, so I decided ki chalo iske bare mein bhi padh lete hain. So increase in cargo capacity at the ports to 1759 million metric ton per annum from 1282 million metric ton per annum in the year 2020. Jo last year kitna tha, 1282, that they will increase to 1759 million metric ton per annum. Cargo movement on all national waterways will be 95 million metric ton from 74 million metric ton in the year 2020. And also remember, cargo movement on Ganga to be increased from 9 MMT to 29 MMT, which is nothing but million metric ton. Okay, 9 MMT से 29 MMT बढ़ाया जाएगा cargo movement on the Ganga River. All right. So this was about this news, guys. And now let's come back to the question. Definitely in future some more news will come from this PM Gati Shakti plan. अभी तक के लिए इतना ही है. In future we will discuss it जब भी जैसे-जैसे इसमें news आती रहेंगी. So it will incorporate the infrastructure schemes of various ministries and state governments like Bharatmala, Sagarmala, etc. Yes, this is the basic essence of this particular project. 11 industrial corridors and 2 defense corridors will be constructed under the plan. Yes, all the infrastructure projects are now subsumed under this, and it will subsume the infrastructure project of 16 ministries. So all the statements are definitely correct, which means option D will be the correct answer. I hope guys PM Gati Shakti plan is clear, and now let's move ahead to question number 2. Another very important question. Which tool has been launched by Union Minister of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj? And who is the minister? Mr. Giriraj Singh. Giriraj Singh's constituency is Begusarai in Bihar. Under MNREGA for the integration of climate information and GIS based watershed planning. This is very important, directly related to government schemes, and the questions related to government schemes, remember, are very, very important for the regulatory body exam specifically, and also for state PCS and UPSC exam. So let's talk about this. So remember, the Union Minister of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj, Mr. Giriraj Singh, has launched the CRISP-M tool. CRISP-M, which is Climate Resilience Information System and Planning, and M stands for MNREGA. CRISP-M tool for MNREGA. Now what this tool will do, ye tool karega kya basically? So remember, it will integrate climate information in GIS based watershed planning. GIS based watershed planning jo hota hai usme climate related information provide karayega, so that the MNREGA workers will have the information regarding the climate change. Agar koi climate change hona hai ya koi weather change bhi hona hai in the near future, the information will be provided to the MNREGA workers. And remember, this tool will be used in 7 states, which are Bihar, Jharkhand, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Rajasthan. These are the 7 states where this tool will be used. Also remember, this tool has been launched in collaboration with the government of UK. If they ask you ki with which country's collaboration this CRISP-M tool was launched, so the answer will be government of United Kingdom, government of UK. And this UK is not Uttarakhand, of course, it is United Kingdom. All right. So this was about this news, and hence the correct answer will be what, guys? Option A, CRISP-M is the tool that has been launched under MNREGA for providing climate related information to the MNREGA workers. Moving ahead to question number 3, another very important question. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to the PLI scheme for telecom and networking products? It was announced earlier, I know. Hum isko dobara se padh rahe hain because that time it was announced and now it has been implemented. ठीक है, इंप्लीमेंट तो वैसे ये 1 अप्रैल से ही है. सो द डिटेल्ड गाइडलाइंस हैव बीन लॉन्च्ड. ओके, सो द पीएलआई स्कीम फॉर टेलीकॉम एंड नेटवर्किंग प्रोडक्ट्स, यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई वन इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आउट ऑफ दीस. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. नाउ कैन यू टेल मी हु इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन? प्लीज राइट डाउन इन द कमेंट्स. बहुत दिन से मैंने कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं पूछा है, तो बहुत टाइम के बाद मैंने आपसे कोई क्वेश्चन पूछा है, तो प्लीज राइट डाउन इन द कमेंट्स हु इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. Ministry of Communication has launched PLI scheme for telecom and networking products, and this is definitely the objective of this particular scheme is to boost the domestic manufacturing in the telecom and networking products by incentivizing the manufacturers. Okay, jo manufacturers hai unko incentivize karke jo telecom and networking products hai unki manufacturing ko boost kiya jayega. That is the objective of this particular scheme. The total outlay, guys, is 1 to 195 crores. Do remember the total outlay, and also remember, if they ask you ki from which date the scheme is being implemented, so that is from 1st of April 2021, and it will continue till financial year 26. That is up to 31st March of 2026 tak ye continue rahega. Okay, talking more about this, so remember, there are 31 companies which have been identified as the eligible companies to get the incentives under this particular PLI scheme. And out of these 31, remember, 16 are MSMEs and 15 are non-MSMEs. And out of these 15 non-MSMEs, 8 are domestic companies and 7 are the global companies. Do remember these facts also. These also they can ask in your exam. Now, these 31 applicants, these 31 eligible companies are expected to invest rupees 3345 crores. 3345 crores in the next 4 years. Agle 4 saalon mein inko 3345 crore rupees invest karna padega and generate increment employment of more than 40,000 people and they have to create employment of more than 40,000 people. Theek hai, so kafi acha hai and incremental production of around 1.82 lakh crores is expected from this particular PLI scheme for telecom and networking products. Okay, so I hope guys this PLI scheme is clear. Itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada nahi padhna hai isme. And of course the implementing ministry is Ministry of Communication. ठीक है, तो ये तो कोई बहुत बेसिक सी बात है. The scheme is effective from 1st April 2021. Absolutely correct. Total 35 companies are eligible. No, these are not 35 companies. There are 31 companies which are eligible. 31 companies है जो कि eligible है. And out of this 31, 16 are MSMEs and 15 are non-MSMEs. And out of 15 non-MSMEs, 8 are domestic and 7 are global. So that's why the correct answer will be what, option B. Moving ahead to question number 4. Again, very important question. Consider the following statements with respect to Global Hunger Index 2021 and you have to identify the correct statement. So, Global Hunger Index 2021 mein India ki rankings ko bahut zyada poor bataya gaya hai and I believe ki itni poor ranking hamari actually mein nahi hai. And of course, Ministry of Women and Child Development ne bhi iska reply dete hue bola hai ki that the method that FAO used, although this report is released by Concern Worldwide and World Hunger Health, but they use the data from the data compiled by Food and Agricultural Organization FAO. So the ministry has cited that the data, the method used for collecting the data by FAO is completely unscientific, and yes, that is unscientific. क्योंकि वो basically एक company है Gallup करके, उससे उन्होंने क्या करा, telecom फोन से टेलीफोनिक डेटा कलेक्ट करवा लिया और उसके थ्रू उन्होंने वो डेटा बना दिया. सो दैट इज नॉट द वे, बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ अंडर नरिशमेंट, इन केस ऑफ मैल न्यूट्रिशन, यू हैव टू गो ऑन द फील्ड टू कलेक्ट द डेटा. दैट वुड बी मोर अप्रोप्रिएट, बट दैट वॉज नॉट डन इन दिस केस. एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस टेलीफोनिक डेटा दे आर सेइंग दैट इंडियाज रैंक इज सो मच पुअर, 101. एंड इवन दे आर सेइंग कि बांग्लादेश एंड नेपाल एंड पाकिस्तान लाइक कंट्रीज विच आर वी ऑल नो इज नॉट, मतलब इतने ज्यादा वेल एस्टैब्लिश कंट्री वो नहीं है कि वो हमसे ऊपर हो जाएंगे. ठीक है, आई एग्री दैट वो हो सकते हैं, बट इन द रिपोर्ट दे आर ऑल्सो सेइंग दैट देर इज नो इफेक्ट ऑफ कोविड ऑन दीज कंट्रीज लाइक नेपाल, बांग्लादेश एंड पाकिस्तान. सो दिस इज इनअप्रोप्रिएट ऑफकोर्स, बट येस द रिपोर्ट हैज बीन रिलीज, सो वी हैव टू स्टडी इट. बट इन माई ओपिनियन इससे क्वेश्चन आएगा नहीं पेपर में, बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट इसका आउट राइटली अपोज किया है. सो आई डोंट थिंक इसका कोई क्वेश्चन आना चाहिए, बट येस यू नेवर नो कि क्या पूछा जा सकता है एग्जाम में. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द ग्लोबल हंगर इंडेक्स. ठीक है, आई बिलीव कि हमारे देश में हंगर की प्रॉब्लम है, बट वी कांट से कि आउट ऑफ 116 कंट्रीज इंडिया वुड बी 101 एंड ओनली 15 कंट्रीज आर वर्स देन अस. ऐसा मैं नहीं मान सकता कि मतलब थोड़ी बहुत तो रैंकिंग मतलब ऊपर होनी ही चाहिए, आई बिलीव. ठीक है, मैं हमेशा से गवर्नमेंट के क्रिटिसिज्म पे रहता हूँ, बट दिस टाइम आई एम विद द गवर्नमेंट. दे आर थिंग राइट, 80 करोड़ लोगों को खाना खिला दिया कोविड में, इससे ज्यादा क्या कर सकती है गवर्नमेंट. ठीक है, दैट इज अ वेरी गुड पार्ट फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया साइड. द ग्लोबल हंगर इंडेक्स 2021 हैज बीन रिलीज बाय कंसर्न वर्ल्ड वाइड एंड वर्ल्ड हंगर हेल्प, एंड दिस इंडेक्स मेजर्स द हंगर एट ग्लोबल, रीजनल एंड कंट्री लेवल्स. ओके, एंड द इंडेक्स इज बेस्ड ऑन 4 इंडिकेटर्स, 4 इंडिकेटर्स पे ये बेस्ड है. दीज आर अंडर नरिशमेंट, चाइल्ड वेस्टिंग, चाइल्ड स्टंटिंग एंड चाइल्ड मॉर्टेलिटी. These are the 4 indicators. Do remember the indicators also, because they can ask how many indicators and which indicators are used for global hunger index. And now इससे related question आपके description में, descriptive वाले part में भी आ सकता है. They can ask, throw some light on the global hunger index 2021 and how and why the government of India criticized this report. Comment. इस तरीके का question इसमें descriptive में भी आ सकता है. All right. Now, moving ahead, scoring 0 to 100 होती है, 0 is the best, 100 is the worst. Total countries है इसमें 116, total countries 116 थी, last year, last time it was I guess 104, now it has been increased to 116. Data collection. Undernourishment data is provided by FAO, headquartered in Rome, Italy. Child mortality data from UN Interagency for Child Mortality Estimation. Then child wasting and stunting data from UNICEF, WHO and World Bank's various reports. Alright. And here, undernourishment data ke baare mein government ne bola hai that have been collected by FAO, that the data collected is completely unscientific. And the points, the stand of the government of India, jo maine aapko bata diya hai, that I will provide in the PDF, jo ki aapko mil jata hai. Isme maine nahi liya hai, I have explained you the stand of the government of India, but PDF mein main dal dunga, don't worry. Now rankings, talking about rankings, so 1 to 18 rankings, 1 se 18 tak koi individual ranking nahi hai, all the countries are equal from the rank 1 to 18. And bottom pe it was Somalia, with the rank 116. India's rank is very poor, 101 with a score of 27.5. Bangladesh and Nepal even are above than us, which are at rank 75. And even Pakistan country, it is above than us with the rank of 92. So this was about this news. And guys, now let's come back to the question. And let me repeat this. I will provide the PDF. I will provide the Government of India stand in the PDF. So waan se kar lena. And there can be a descriptive question from this part. From this index. So the index is based on 6 indicators? No. It is based on 4 indicators. Total number of countries are 120? No. It was 116. Bottom ranked country is Eritrea? No. It was Somalia. So sorry, incorrect. India's rank is not 94. That's 101. So all the statements are incorrect here, which means none is correct. Option E will be the correct answer because we have to identify the correct statement. Moving ahead to the last question for today, question number 5, which edition of Delhi Shri Sea Power Seminar? Isme agar question aaya to sirf yahi hoga, isme isse zyada detail mein nahi jana hai. Which edition of Delhi Shri Sea Power Seminar was held with the theme Maritime History of the Indian Ocean Region? Maritime History of the Indian Ocean Region theme tha, and you have to tell the edition. So remember, that was the 8th edition. Ye 8th edition tha of the Delhi Shri Sea Power Seminar, and it was conducted on the Indian Navy official YouTube channel and Facebook channel. The theme was Maritime History of the Indian Ocean Region, and these are the 3 sub themes. There were sub themes also, the 3 sub themes, and you do not have to remember 3 sub themes. Ye yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. Just read it out once from the PDF. Early maritime interactions and relevance today, India's maritime journey from 15th to 19th century and key takeaways in the 21st century. And lessons learned from India's maritime journey, British Raj, independence and beyond. No need to remember all the sub themes, just remember the basic themes and the edition, which edition of this seminar was. So this was the 8th edition, that's why the correct answer will be what? Option E, 8th edition. So that's it for the session guys, I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll see you tomorrow, Wednesday ko, jaisa ki session hota hai, continuously hota rahega. Thank you so much. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.